Plants evolved here on Earth, but what if we could take them with us to the stars? Hey gang, Trace here for DNews with your weekly space update. Last year, NASA announced that we had found water on Mars. And that got some people thinking, could future astronauts grow crops in the Martian soil? It's taken us thousands of years to hone farming here on Earth. We could, like, plant crops till the cows come home, but what's good for the Earth's goose may not be good for the Martian gander, if you know what I mean. Soil needs a lot more than water to grow a plant. Soil on Earth contains living and dead organisms, including bacteria and plant matter, rocks and minerals, and nutrients like nitrogen. It takes more than 500 years to form an inch of topsoil on Earth. And as far as we know, Mars doesn't have organisms living in its soil to aerate it and break down the matter. So this is a huge challenge. Not all dirt is created equal. There are actually 70,000 different kinds of soil in the United States alone. So to simulate Martian soil, we had to gather information about Mars first. The Mars Science Laboratory Curiosity has been doing just that when it wasn't joyriding around Mars and snapping selfies, of course. Martian soil contains carbon dioxide, oxygen, and sulfur compounds, as well as carbonates, or things that indicate a presence of water. It's about 2% water. NASA gathered soil samples on Mars and then composed an approximation of Martian soil using volcanic soil from Hawaii. From there, plant ecologist Wieger Wamelink planted 14 plants and grew them over 50 days. Obviously, the plants were given carbon dioxide, oxygen, and water, but that's just the obvious resources. The seeds of a plant can sustain growth for a while. That's what they're for, to help the plant gain a foothold. But according to PhysOrg, they expected the plants to germinate and then die due to a lack of nutrients. The researchers were surprised to find that the plants actually did pretty well, using the phosphorus and iron oxides in the soil to take root. Unfortunately, the fact that the plants grew in a difficult soil environment is only one small part of the puzzle. The lower gravity and temperature of Mars will make it difficult for water to be pulled into the soil and tougher for the plants to evaporate their excess moisture. Plus, the sun is a lot farther away, so any Martian plants are going to need extra light. They're thinking LEDs at the moment, but no one is really quite sure. The moon is much closer, only a few days away, so to Newt Gingrich's delight, the moon will probably be the location of Earth's first extraterrestrial colony. Wamelink is also trying to grow crops in the moon's soil called regolith. Because our moon has no atmosphere, the regolith contains mainly meteorite-pummeled rock dust, micrometeor debris, rocks, and volcanic glass. Not to mention radiation from the unchecked solar wind. Yay. It would be huge if we can manage to get crops to take root in any capacity on another planet, not only because of food, but oxygen recycling purposes, and to give, you know, colonists something to do all day. It can get pretty boring to sit around in a spacecraft all the time, but that's another story. And if this doesn't give you the train conductor kick in the head excitement about the future, how about Shots of Awe with Jason Silva? Watch Jason explore technology, space, human nature, and love.
The first thing we love is a scene, which is seen for the first time. Curtain parts, and what had never been seen is devoured by the eyes.
Whoa, what does your gut tell you? Are Earth plants gonna grow on the moon or Mars? Tell us below and subscribe for more DNews.